it did have a few times through the ranking system, but always fell out of qualified after a while. Players like HDHR and Orbital coming out with FCs on it during its time, but now it's sitting in the love category, so if you want to, you can go and attempt to go on the leaderboard. I've tried and failed. That's another tale for another time.
It looks like we are about to get into this first warm-up. Headphone warning, just forewarning you. On Mexico side, we have Hebel, Wolfie, Aeon Lust, and Ferelix in the room right now. And on the Spanish side, we have Naxirin, Pain Getsu, PD Prox, and Mortal Striker.
Right, so this will be... I do not know what to expect from the map. I know the song to a degree. So we could probably, maybe there might be a jump section in the chorus. There might be a slow lead up in the beginning. And we can expect the ears to be grinded off every single person who's listening, because it's a cover of it. And the covers of these songs usually don't go very well. But I'm not one to denigrate the work of others, so maybe you all love it.
It definitely could be worse. I've definitely heard worse, I can say that much.
Some things come to mind, like Die Die Jerome and certain covers of Snow Drive. But, oh god, indeed. You have to remember, we've been listening to this for approximately 10 minutes now. I've gone through 4 loops of this song. So this is very fun for me.
You feel that pain, just for a moment. I shouldn't knock it, actually. Borneko, I bet he's a cool guy. I bet Borneko's a cool guy.
It's just... Oh, look at it. It's got the sunglasses on, it's got the face photoshopped in. This is going to be superb. We've got Aeon Lust going with a hidden hard rock in the warm-up. Wolfie deciding spinning is not cool. So we've got relatively poor accuracy coming out of some players and from the singer. So we've got some FCs coming out, we've got full FCs coming out on the side of Mexico, we've got 2 on the side of Spain, Painketsu and Mortal Striker unfortunately missing quite early on, and Painketsu will drop as well. We're going through the slow section now. Maybe it was, we have a jump section coming up or something similar. Haven't seen the map before, so I can't predict exactly.
This is like a fairly standard one. Not the same as the ranked one, obviously. It's like one short first, but yeah, it's definitely a different version.
We've got some Cursor Dancer coming out from Wolfie. Oh, here's the jumps if there are any. Fairly safe with the star pattern, with a few 5 streams coming out.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be screen jumps or something.
That was fairly forgiving. Oh, we've got some hearts coming out from the Mexican side. Wolfie. Oh, cider breaking has cost him his combination. Oh, PD Prox drops the second highest combo on the field, so Hebel now is the only FC. Mortal Striker missing very early on, so he is lagging a bit behind, but he's coming closer. And we've got Spain with the point lead. Oh, that pattern's quite nice with the almost squares, but not quite.
Yeah,
To be honest, I was expecting screen jumps to fill a large portion of this map, because a lot of these covers do seem to, when they are mapped, they appear to be 6-7 stars for songs that would otherwise not warrant it.
Yeah. It does seem like it's enough to warm up on these kind of maps, though. Some tricky slider patterns here and there, so...
Long gone are the days where people would just put on the 8 stars, the various well-known maps and the warm-ups, which have been a prominent feature in previous World Cups.
Mm-hmm.
But people seem to be relaxing a little bit.
You don't always see the Arles maps and all that Rambit jumping style maps come out. Like we saw last year, quite a lot of teams just go in completely ham with it. And there we go. There's that warm-up done.
So...
My ears are blessed.
I feel like we've done rather well to survive that. And full credit to everyone who stayed with us. So Mortal Striker with the S, he did slide a break early on, but he does get the highest combo in the end. So he stumbles early, but carries on through to give a good performance. Oh no.
I get a feeling we're getting another troll one.
So it's a minute long. It's 150 beats per minute. And it's 7.2 stars. So, and it's called Under Trump. And the difficulty name is Make America Great Again. Now, here we cannot lean politically either direction, so we're going to say that we're just going to enjoy the map.
It's going to be a nice tune. Well, I mean, like, at the end of the day, of course, they're just playing for pride here, so why not have some fun with it? Troll warm-ups are always nice. I know the UK team likes to pull out a few, but yeah.
Oh, what would be a typical map that the UK team might pull out in warm-ups?
Well, it'd be one of two things. It'd be either A, some 7-star thing, or B, some silly tune. Well, granted, we played Ice Cream Cake earlier, which isn't really either of those things. It is I'd say it's 7 stars in the sense of its patterns. It's usually one of those two.
Oh dear, this song.
Oh gee, if only they had video playing. I'm sure it sounds like it should have a video with it, really. You can just hear those audio.
It really does, yeah.
Little bits and bobs.
God's sake. Oh, the song is getting to me. I feel like this song's trying to get a message across, but I can't quite work out what it is.
No. I think he's a builder.
Mr. Trump, it has not escaped anybody's notice that you say that the Mexican government...
Oh dear, the voice of the moderator. He was in the second or third debate? I can't quite remember. Might have been, I think he was in the last debate. Apparently this map is only 7 stars because of spinners, but that will be quite exciting.
Wait, 7 stars because of spinners? What?
Yes.
Okay.
Apparently, spinners can do that. Oh, yeah, there was you have like various like 9 and 11 star maps which just have like a constant spinner, and the way it works is it's really, really slow spinner. So you can actually have like patterns going around, and as long as you're like holding down sliders as you go around the map, or like circle around, you actually fulfill the spinner. So it's like invisible spinners and things like that. So maps which have that kind of thing incorporated are quite cool. I find personally.
Oh god, yeah, I've just been reminded of that one map for, I think it was Brain Power, where they had loads of spinners during the choruses with streams, and it was like 12 stars or something.
Yeah, but yes, that was the one I was thinking of as well. I couldn't quite remember which song it was. Oh, I've just quite... it did take me a while, but I just realised that this song is discussing building a wall between two certain countries, and one of them is in this match, so... That was a...
Yep.
I've literally just not even thought about that, but... Oh, look at his smug face. Oh, lots of people drawing squares. Oh, or maybe just walls. Mr.
Trump, it has not escaped... Yeah, I really hope Stream has video enabled for this one. Probably not, but we can dream.
So we've got full combos coming out. Oh, actually, we've got Widdlelux 13 unfortunately dropping. Maybe it'll come back to bite him. Oh, he drops again. Mortal Striker as well. So we've got full combos coming out from every player on the Mexican side. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Oh, I was hoping we'd see like the first three-way seven-star FC or something, because I've never seen that. Never seen three players FC a seven-star map in a tournament before, but we're not going to see it here.
So C is the letter of the day.
Two solid warm-ups there. Just having some fun with it. But now we're going to get into the bans and get into this actual match to see which of these two can take home some national pride here.
My client is messed up a bit.
Yeah, you still have to nurse it home. Yeah, I think it's fine my end, but every now and again, you just got to nurse it home. Wolfie rolls a 52. Just waiting on that Spanish roll to see who bans first. Of course, the loser of the roll bans first, but the winner picks first. Is how that works.
Indeed.
While that goes, we'll bring the game back to you in just a moment, while we get things sorted.
Oh, Naxxerion with a disappointing roll of only 29 falls quite short compared to the 52 of Wolfie. He's really going to be kicking himself for that one. Spain will ban first, and as you said, Mexico will have the first pick.
With Mexico having a higher concentration of higher ranked, more mechanically adept players, I can imagine banning some of the harder maps. But, that's not going to be the case. FI has been banned. But then again, maybe, because a lot of people like to pick harder ones, as opposed to no mod. The larger CS can be a little bit disorienting for players. I know I find it, large circle size can be a bit disorienting to read. But
yeah, I find it easier to combo with the harder one. And it's one of those maps which, if you feel that in general your skill level might be like on average lower, it's one of those maps which a good player can just slap on Hidden Hard Rock and they will be able to like combo with like 98, 99. It's quite difficult to beat if one or more of the enemy team is doing Hard Rock or Hidden. There's a lot of room to show player skill.
I do wonder why they picked that over some of the other three mods, because I feel like the other two, Remake and For My Soul, are more difficult. And I think Mexico's higher skill cap in that regard would do better on those, but it's up to Spain. They've banned FI.
they have chosen, we can question.
Oh yeah, looks like Mexico band. How do you do? Lost that in the middle of the chat window. How do you do? The Hard Rock pick has been banned for Mexico.
I read that as a question as well.
Yeah. So
I'm just doing that all day.
Feeling everyone read that as the question. Because it makes perfect sense as a question.
How do you do Hard Rock? I don't know.
How do you do it?
Slap on AR-10, play it for a while, hope you can get some accuracy, and then come out at the end of the day, play a 5-minute long map and get 300 PP. That's
Thank you so much for the wisdom.
Or 400, or 500, or 700, or 800, depending on where you fall on the skill ladder. So, Hard Rock does seem to be the mod seen everywhere at all the skill levels. So. Oh, Golden Slaughter are coming out.
Yep. Golden Slaughter, it looks like. Double time coming out of Mexico. 201 BPM, very stream heavy to start this one out.
This is one of the maps where you do have to warm up a bit beforehand. Because even 200 BPM, is you do have to warm up a bit. So. You'll see players possibly dropping into the low accuracies on this map, as you've seen before, with some players falling into the low 90s, some even to the 80s. But it's, you can expect most players to be able to do fairly well in the combo department.
Seeing a few player swaps here. It's like Painketsu and Widowlux coming in for the the Spanish side. Still waiting on that one last slot for Mexico to fill before we go.
Wait, smoke? No, I've got the. Oh, cable gone. Alright, yes. My climb was slightly bugged. So you've got Atsuro coming in for Mexico.
Atsuro? I actually know Atsuro more for his mapping than his playing, but I do know he has a pretty high rank. Let's see what he can do here. That's quite a few Dragon Force tunes, I believe.
Yes, indeed. Alright, looking at his profile, when he comes out, he's less than a minute ago, he's got a double time FC on Golden Slaughterer, so he's got his practice in.
There you go.
He's arrived prepared, maybe a little last minute, who knows.
That's the thing, actually, I mean, of course, before you go to play a map, you know, say, oh, guys, I FC'd this map, put me in. And then when you get into the actual lobby and it's time to do the business. So if you're overconfident on a map, that can sometimes bite you because you can easily just slip up.
You just have a lapse in concentration, then you realize you've missed in the first 100 combo, and then everything else is just, you feel like you're clawing it back and you never quite feel right during the rest of the match. So at least I found that during my attempts to win the UK Cups. That happened to me. Got an SS coming up from Naxxerian so far. Starting out pretty slow, but only he has maintained the SS.
Seeing those accuracy drops early on.
Oh, Painketsu with the early drop.
With the accuracy as well, and a bit of a rough start, but it is early on, with plenty of combo to go. With the streams coming up, I imagine we'll see act drops from the Mexican side, so if you can hold on then, you can definitely...
Oh, another drop coming out in Spain. The lead is opening up a little bit. Oh, Widowlux is having a little bit of a difficulty trying to climb back into it. Yeah, the accuracy on the Mexican side is falling a little bit, but they are holding with 4 FCs, so... and the longest stream of the map, and Mexico holds strong. The two FCs are on the Spanish side. Painkatsu is 100 off, but White Lux, he's having a little bit of a hard time trying to cut back into it. 400,000 point difference now.
Running out of time to make that back up, though.
Yeah, it's, and with the accuracy drop, they need several drops from Mexico in the next few notes, really. And now it's almost too late.
Props to Naxarin, though. Holding that really incredible accuracy, actually. We don't see many people holding almost 99 on this, but it's not enough. His team is breaking too much, and Mexico are running away with it. 500,000 in the lead now.
Yeah. Fortunately, Naxarin, even with Canada, I think they 4-0'd, and they had quite a few FCs, I think three FCs on this in their last match, and none of them managed to get above like 98.5, so Naxarin really showing that he's got quite a lot going for him in the accuracy department, but unfortunately with two Bs on his side with only one other FC, just it's not quite enough.
Two FCs to two both sides, but that accuracy winning the day for Mexico, 1-0.
Wolfier stated his ACK is a joke, and his aim apparently. He's not feeling very confident, but he was sitting there with one of the FCs, so in fact the highest score on his team, so everything's not going all bad.
Spain's next pick. I do wonder what they'll pick. Of course, Mexico banned out that hard rock. You wonder if they're going to try that other hard rock that has been left, a Utopia? Or if they'll leave that for later.
I haven't seen Utopia played, so I'll be interested to see that. Most people seem to be staying mostly away from the no-mod picks in these matches over time. So, and if they do, they usually go for the Altair or sometimes the Skystar. Pinpon map.
It's kind of a surprise, actually. You normally see the majority of picks being no-mod because it's safer, but not this time. In other matches I've casted, there's definitely been a lot of no-mod, but matches I've casted here have been going out of the comfort zone a little bit.
Indeed they have been. Oh, so we're just having waiting a little bit on Spain. So they're just deciding between themselves. Have you seen much of Skyclad being played? Because that seems like a map that some people would stay away from because of it's quite... People just generally shy away from AR8 in tournaments.
It's been picked a couple of times, actually. It's been picked a lot more than Blumenkranz, the AR8 hidden.
I think a couple of times is a bit of an understatement.
Right, actually, so.
22.
Yeah.
22 times.
It is the second most picked map alongside Atale.
Well, that is entirely my fault for not watching quite enough.
Yeah, that's been a popular one. I know in the UK matches we picked it pretty much every match, and if we didn't pick it, they picked it, so...
Oh, and we do have the Hard Rock pick, so well done you for predicting that one.
Clearly a pick based off that ban, this one. Whether they'll dominate on it, I don't know. With it being a short hard rock pick, it could definitely go either way. Even if you're not entirely comfortable on it, you could definitely get a very lucky FC.
Yeah, you don't have to deal with the shorter maps, it's easier to... I wouldn't say get lucky or be unlucky. I just say it's like chance does play more of a role because... It's much easier. Mistakes mean a lot more in the shorter maps, so. Especially with Hard Rock, because it is the most volatile of the mods, for the most part. There's been quite a lot of, in the last year or two, lots and lots of drum and bass songs being mapped, and they all seem to be relatively relaxing picks for this kind of thing.
That's lots true. They tend to be, quite simple in rhythm, yeah. Because they tend to just map to the 1/4 rhythm with some, you know, very simple bursts. So when it comes to picking like mod maps for tournaments, this kind of thing has a simple rhythm to follow. So it's more down to just reading the visual aspect of it, as opposed to just dealing with the rhythm aspect.
Maps like that, I think, are quite relaxing. I think one of the first ones that I really noticed was United. That is like the one that everyone pretty much knows. That's just started with the drum and bass, and then you've got a lot more, like Asphyxia was mapping a lot of them. I can't remember particular names of them, but there were quite a lot. And they seem to be quite a staple of like the 4.5 to 5.5 star rating, kind of relatively low BPM stuff. So we've got our first hard rock pick. And only. So we're starting off fairly strongly. Oh, two misses coming out, one from Spain, one from Mexico. So Ferrolix and Nexurian both dropping. And accuracy seems to be fairly low across the board, and Nexurian missing again. So we've got a score lead coming up from Mexico with about 100,000, or maybe 50,000 now. It's dropping now. So with that Euro missing, we're past the halfway point now. So Spain are looking pretty good. And oh, two drops though, that can cost them. A Ferrolix drops on the side of Mexico, so this could go either way. Oh, this is very, very back and forth. It looks as though, as we come to the closing few notes, that Mexico will take it, with the full combos coming out from Wolfie and Aeon Must. And only one full combo coming out from the side of Spain. So
the comeback, though. Spain had that lead most of the way, just couldn't hold on to it.
There was a bit there where, like, every single note, or rather pattern, the lead was switching. So that was quite interesting.
Almost looked like that pick worked, but Mexico's quality shining through with Wolfie and Aeon Lust. Holding nice FCs there. Mortal Striker with a solid FC as well, but it wasn't enough. Again, Wolfie's and Aeon Lust accuracy, just having it on that map. 2-0 to Mexico.
2-0, and now Mexico get their pick. So now they can, if they take this next map, then Spain have that long, grueling task of having to take the three maps and then also going to the tiebreaker. Whereas Mexico will then, if they win this next pick, then they will have match point for quite a while.
We'll just have a quick update on the other matches going on right now. Between the US and Austria, the US is currently 2-0 up. In the match between Brazil and Sweden, it's currently 1-1. Close game over there.
Indeed. So, what are we going to see? So, we're waiting to see the next pick coming out from Mexico. We've got Harry Nosora. Okay. I'm very apprehensive to try and pronounce anything that isn't written in the Queen's English, which is a slight problem. But I'm sure I'll get over it in time.
You should get there in the end. You can always go with that one DT pick or that other no model one. Yes, people get fed up. But Harry Nasora is going to be the DT pick. Now, not as streamy as Golden Slaughterer. Still fairly streamy though. Small circle size at circle size 5. Some slider, spam sections. All in all, it's a fairly standard double time pick coming out here.
But it's still fairly difficult, hard to maintain a good accuracy on, so. And smaller circle size does lend itself to random misses.
It does. This one isn't terribly jumpy though. There are a few sections where the spacing increases, but for the most part, it's fairly low space, just apart from some space streams here and there, so. I don't think the CS is too tricky on this. It feels more like a standard one, but of course, compared to Golden Slaughterer, which is the circle size 4, more standard layout. This is a little bit different to that.
Yeah, I quite enjoy low circle size stuff. It feels much more satisfying here, rather, I think, compared to the lower stuff. So we are just kind of seeing through, seeing what Octave is asking if everyone's ready. So shortly we will be heading into the third pick and see if Mexico can get to themselves to the point of match point. Or Spain can save themselves from the tiebreaker if they wish to go that far.
So that last map was definitely competitive. Spain almost had them. Of course, one's got to expect that's their strength. Considering Mexico were banded out and Spain seemed pretty decent on that up until the end. If they can combat Mexico on the other mods, it'll be great. But you've got to say, Mexico will be looking pretty strong on this one. We'll see how they do.
Starting going through the streamy bit now. Let's see, we've got one miss coming out on the side of Spain, so Penkatsu is going to be dropping, sitting below 90% accuracy. Naxxuren sitting with 99, with the highest accuracy on the board. In fact, everyone seems to be below 96 apart from him, so once again on the DT picks he seems to have the accuracy on lock. And just to keep everyone updated, the United States has won 4-0 over Austria.
A update from the other match though, actually, and an interesting one as well. Sweden has gone 2-1 up against Brazil in their match. Despite a SS on Mikanse from Mouse Easy, Sweden have taken the lead in that match.
And in this match we're watching right now, we've got one FC on the side of Spain with Mortal Striker holding strong, but actually only one on the side of Mexico as well with Wolfie. So Naxxuren has missed along with PD Prox and Penkatsu, so combos are sitting fairly low, so this map could go either way, as before. We're gonna have a little bit of stream before the break. So it's basically up to Mortal Striker and Wolfie, really, and the combined efforts of their three teammates, but if either of one of them breaks, then I think that may decide the match.
Is very close, really, because the accuracy is in favor of Spain ever so slightly. There goes Wolfie. Oh. Spain could be taking it now if they hold on for just a few moments.
Mortal Striker just needs to hold this combo. The accuracy may not be the best, but he gets through the slightly space stream now. The final jump happens. He's cruising on through, and Naxxuren building up that combo as well with a decent accuracy. Provided nothing goes horribly wrong here, no fails or anything like that, it looks as though Spain will be taking this match and saving themselves from the grueling task of getting back only to get to the tiebreaker, so they can hold their heads high after this one.
It's just what they needed. I mean, if it was 3-0, you couldn't really see a way back for Spain, to be honest. But there you go, a handy win for Spain to bring it 2-1, just over 200k of advantage right there. Wolfie with that slider break. The Mortal Strikers combo winning the day with his FC and AFC due to the accuracy, but it was plenty to win his win this map for his team.
So, updates from Group F. We have the US sitting at number one and Norway sitting at number two, with all matches being played. So Denmark and Austria, unfortunately, will go out.
Denmark, same. So Slokas.
Mortal Strikers wondered where his axe gone. In fact, he's got the FCA, which is not too common.
It really is uncommon, but it was enough for his team. And I was just mentioning about Denmark in that group. Came so close to defeating the US, but no cigar, because they actually took him to tiebreaker and only avoided... Well, he won 9 maps, lost 10, despite only winning 1 match, so unfortunate for them.
Oh, for my soul, here we go.
Not
wasting
any time.
Are we
going to
see the AR8 hidden?
It wouldn't surprise me to see a few AR8 hints on this, considering they're playing for pride. Rudic coming in, the captain for Mexico.
Indeed. So at this point, yeah, people aren't playing for... They aren't trying to absolutely try their hardest, so they might show off the fact that they are the ones who can read the AR8 hidden, which anyone who FC'd that would be up there in my books. So. Maybe it's something to do with the fact that I'm one of those people who can't read anything below AR9, so I find that anyone who can do anything like that a god, almost. So, we're waiting on two players from Spain.
Trying to get Adrilolo in, it looks like. There we go, he is in the match.
Adrilolo the 9th. I assume Adrilolo 1, 2, and through to 8 were taken.
Popular name. And the fourth player, wonder who it's going to be. I'm going to see Painketsu. Looks like Painketsu is getting a lot of love from chat, I've noticed.
Yeah,
or is it
going to
be somewhere
else?
Very popular.
Could have a PD proxy with Painketsu. We haven't seen Froz up in here.
Everyone wants to play For My Soul, it looks like. Well, it is one of those maps. It's like, For My Soul, I don't think anyone says they're good at that.
It's just one of those maps where you just like, you join the lobby, hope that you don't have to be the one who's no modding it, and then you slap on the hard rock and hope you don't miss on the slightly annoying streams. And then you just kind of get through it, really.
Pretty much.
It stays fairly consistent in its difficulty the whole way through, so it's just like, it's almost like one of those tests, you know, at the end of the year, you know, just gonna... It's not difficult, it's not particularly hard, it's not surprising, you know what you're getting into, you just have to kind of tough it out.
Just have to give it a good go. We've seen lots of players just picking hard rock on it and forgoing no mod entirely. And there we go, Painketsu coming in for the Spanish team.
Oh boy, I'm looking forward to this. So everyone is here, so Frost can't play. Rest in peace. So we should be getting underway fairly shortly. Hopefully. Maybe. Possibly.
Most likely, I think, yeah. A quick update from the Brazil and Sweden game. It looks like Brazil has pulled a point back to bring it back to 2-2.
All right, here we go. We've got Aeon Nos with the hidden hard rock. We've got two no mods from the side of Mexico and Brudich with the hidden. So, and for the side of Spain, we've got two hard rocks, one hidden hard rock, and Pain Ketsu with the no mod. So, Mexico feeling pretty confident in their reading. Oh, peoples are coming to the first stream. It is fairly evil.
Yeah, quite a few breaks across the board. Only three FCs left, I believe.
Yep, Aeon Lust, Mortal Striker, and Adrololo 9 are cruising through with the higher combos. Naxxerian again missing quite early. He's the hard, hidden hard rocker for the side of Spain. So, we're kind of rooting for Aeon Lust here. We haven't seen a hidden hard rock FC on it so far, I think. So, Kyle was the one in the Canada match who had the hard rock FC, about 98% accuracy, which is fairly impressive. Mortal Striker remains the only full combo so far. The hard rock only pick seems to be doing quite well in that regard.
Yep, it worked out last time as well when Canada had to, well, until the end. Kyle had the FC, I believe. Yeah, the hard rock working well on this. Just so many people prefer to play this hard rock over no mod. You see people doing genuinely better.
It is just the reading. Oh, Adrololo, come on. Don't be like that.
Yep.
You might be interested in this, but for my soul, so far there have been 6 hidden plays, 47 hard rock, and 43 hidden hard rock.
So yeah, everyone just basically runs away from the ER8 with the tail between their legs, really. Aeon Lust sitting at the 93% B, one of the rarer things in this game. Got Wolfie and Asuro sitting at 97-ish, but the FCs are looking fairly... this is Mortal Striker once again being the low-arc full combo hero. Well, maintaining any kind of accuracy on these streams and patterns is just a hard task for anyone. And we've got Spain coming into the lead now. It's got some combos coming out the side of Mexico and two relatively high combos on the side of Spain, so there is some room left for someone to drop, but it looks fairly difficult for Mexico to make a comeback here.
I don't think there's enough time. Maybe just about if Spain completely bottle it, but I doubt it. The combos from Naxxer and Mortal Striker and Adrololo now as well. They're going to be doing the job. I think they're going to be bringing this one back. Actually, considering Naxxerin, he broke at the start, but his accuracy is pretty solid for this map since then.
Yeah, he's done. He's been the accuracy savior of this match in general. With both DT picks, he was doing very well in that regard. Mortal Striker with the... Is he going to full combo here? He's got just a bit more to go. Got the slightly annoying sliders at the end. You can do it, buddy. There we go. So, is it going to be another AFC?
I think so, yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, no, it's the S this time. So, he's the only S on the board. Naxxerian sitting with 97% accuracy with the hidden hard rock. Adrololo 9 with the one miss. So, got a lot of one miss plays on this map so far. And Painketsu sitting there with the B. He's tried his best. He's done well. So we've got Spain taking the map. So next team to pick is going to be Mexico.
So well done to Spain to bring it back 2-2 against the high seed, making it a more competitive one. It looked like it might have run away for them when it was 2-0, but nope, not at all.
Striker saves us, or saves Spain with the FC on the DT pick. So yeah, Spain generally seem to be doing quite well, the DT stuff. So let's see. Oh, Old Tail is the pick from Mexico. So it's the good old early sliders into a relaxing, relatively low BPM map, which is to be played and enjoyed by all.
Mm-hmm. Pretty safe one. Lots of FCs been recorded so far on this. Down to that accuracy war again, pretty much. I think at this point, breaks at the start won't be too likely. Of course, they're possible, but we tend to see this map very early on, like in the first two maps, so people go in there while still being relatively shaky and not quite prepared, so that's when those early bricks come in.
You kind of buffer it almost, you use the Old Tail as like a buffer, so like it doesn't really matter if you're too shaky on that map because it's it's low circle size, the patterns aren't very complex, it's not many like hard jumps, so you can kind of just get through it and use it to kind of calm your nerves a bit. But here it's just going to be used in the point of 2-2, so Mexico just want a pick where they can just kind of show off their accuracy and just show why they are the higher seed.
A quick update on Brazil versus Sweden. 3-2 to Brazil now. They've taken the lead once again on match point right now to seal their second place.
One thing I do like about Scorby 2 is it does make the accuracy war a constant kind of thing, rather than it's like it only happens in a select few scenarios that used to happen in old World Cups.
That's true.
It does come with the drawback of like not having like the hype of having the one person doing the 1v4 carry, but I think the accuracy being a bigger part is quite important.
Yeah, I missed that too. Doesn't work no more, but yeah. At least you don't get the situation where a 99% with one miss in the middle gets beat by 80% for coming.
Oh yeah, that did used to happen quite a bit. It's basically like you would see people like spamming through difficult sections just to maintain the combo, and then like they would forgo accuracy almost entirely, whereas now it's not. It's still kind of worth it, but you don't see it quite so much anymore. And we've got the full 8 FCs coming out, although the accuracy is dropping a fair bit on the Spanish side, so there's a tiny bit of a lead being held by Mexico, but nothing that can't be overcome. And we're heading into the stream section. Ooh, had a miss. Who is it? We've got Athenion missing. So 4 FCs on the side of Spain, so... Oh, and the drop from Painkatsu.
Still 3-2, though. And accuracy-wise, it's pretty even. Actually, no, it's not. Wolfie Hebel really having that accuracy game on point, but they need to make up for that combo that they're missing. There's not many notes left.
Yeah, this is going to be very difficult to... Unless someone drops fairly soon from the Spanish side, it's going to be quite difficult to come back. Although, there is a space stream coming up where if they do miss on that, there is a chance that Mexico could pull it through. I think it's coming up just soon enough. There we go, and everyone makes it through except Painkatsu.
He didn't hold a major combo though, so they're not missing out on too much. I think they'll just be able to make it through. Yeah, the slow, calm end with a 100k in advantage. Pretty safe for them, and that's going to be a 3-2 point for Spain now, surely. Bringing it back from 2-0 down. Wow.
Yeah, so they're really kind of pulling themselves up by the bootstraps, so to speak, and going for it. Maybe Mexico? Yep. I think they're just kind of... They'll be slightly disappointed that they kind of missed in the middle of this map. Because it's not too difficult, and it's just kind of... You're almost playing against yourself, really, in this kind of map. And you see the guess coming out, it was a cider break in the middle, and a cider break for Athenion as well, so... And in fact, the only miss in the entire match comes from Painkatsu. Oh dear. Although we did have higher combo than two players on Mexican side, so it's not all bad.
Yeah, it worked out for him in the end. Next pick is Spain's as well, with a match point on the line to try and claw this win. Of course, if Spain win this, Spain will finish third. Mexico will finish dead last in their group. As the high-seeded team, Mexico really don't want that. They really should bring this one back. Like it's going to be Hajimeta Girls, I think. Yep. The swing map coming out now.
Just going for the tin pond.
Yeah, that
there
works.
We go. Players seem to be doing that as well. It's a fairly easy cop out. And Dave is from slightly questionable pronunciation. So, the BPM change map incarnate. So, before we started this cast session, I did have a go at it and missed several times at the doubles and then rage quit because I was annoyed about at myself. So,
yeah, this map's just full of parts, so you can just bugger up entirely. Lots of changing spacing as well between the singles, and the streams are always in different spacing each time. Very variable, this kind of thing. Something you can't just sight read and just bash out in FC4. Unless you're a top level player. For the most part, you're going to need to have played it before. I'm sure these guys have. But it's not a not a comfortable one by any means. We'll see this get to tiebreaker though. Another tiebreaker. Seems like we've had loads this group stage. I don't know how many times that map's been played.
Oh yeah, have you said, I don't know if you said already, but Brazil and Sweden are sitting at 3-3 with a tiebreaker to be played.
Oh, okay,
that
yeah.
That'd be interesting.
Wow. Because the thing is with that, if Brazil lose that match, Hong Kong go through, I'm pretty sure. Let me put the stats actually, let's double check that. Actually, yes, because Brazil need to win two matches. They've won one, lost one, and Hong Kong have won two. So Brazil need to win that to go through.
Indeed, they do. I'll be keeping an eye on that as well. Also, Froz is now in the lobby, so I believe we are almost ready to get underway.
Getting back to this match though, looks like we're about to go with this pick. Can Spain lock out their win over the high seed in Mexico, or are we going to be seeing a tiebreak around here? Let's find out.
Right. Let's enjoy the bit where everyone gets the full combo before things get a little bit hectic. Or not. Fair few early misses coming out from Spain, so Mexico will take the early lead. Although everything's about to get a bit harder.
Here come the jumps.
Oh, that's a lot of misses.
Everyone apart from PD Proc on Spain's end. Is that going to be enough to bring this back? Maybe.
It may well be. If anyone misses on the side of Mexico now, and Spain just keeps comboing, then this could be very easily a way for them to come through. Oh, Froz is going to miss, but we've got still two people holding the lesser combo now, and PD Proc hasn't missed. Oh no, he's going to kick himself for that one.
They've taken the lead though. But is it enough? I mean, combo-wise, Mexico are edging it, but is that enough to overtake it? I don't think they do.
Ah, no, they're gonna lose it. Now, Brudic and Atsuro having the combo, yeah, they're barely going to clinch it. Oh, Athenion almost loses it.
I don't think they can spin to win that.
Oh, that was very close. Oh, that was 5,000 difference. So, no, they could have spun to one that, I think.
Yeah, that was one close.
Point. So now we have a... Let me just get this right. We do have a tiebreaker indeed. Now we get to witness the playing with fire.
Playing with fire.
Can not tiebreakers. Are you kidding me?
That is a lot of tiebreakers. There's been so many close matches. I'm struggling to remember that many 4-0s, to be honest with you. I mean, there was a few, but like, normally, in other tournaments, we have seen quite a lot of those, especially with top seed versus low seed and whatnot, but there has not been nearly as many this group stage. It's been really close.
Most of the Suarez are coming from, well, you had like Italy versus Ukraine, that was one of the ones, but like you got China and Poland doing a lot of them. You got a lot more 4-1s than anything else, really. It seems to be things like 4-2 or 4-1. So, Petey Pox should be 100% D, doing pretty well. Join the rest of us mortals in this lobby.
I think Spain have done well to bring it back to this point. Coming back from 2-0 down against a high C team, it was a show of guts to bring them to this point. I do have to be honest though, I think at this point the quality is going to show through. This map is a very technical map, full of doubles and tricky rhythms, as is fitting for sort of the Mario.
Oh, am I reading that correctly? Someone's going Hidden Hard Rock. Who is it going to be? I am eager to see. It's either Nexurin or Painketsu, because those are the two people that responded. I wouldn't be surprised if Nexurin. He had a relatively good accuracy with a one miss on the AR. I can't remember the name of that. And Painketsu might do it just for the giggles. So this map is quite fun indeed.
It is a really fun map, actually. I tried playing it shortly after the maps were announced. It was a ton of fun, but super long map, over 2k of combo. It's fitting for Club Breaker. I feel like Mexico would have the edge.
And it's the kind of map where if you are good at reading and your aim is reliable and you are consistent, then you can expect to do well. But okay, we've got one hard rock and one hidden hard rock on this map in total, apparently, according to our dear admin, so... Oh, wait. There we go. So we've got Atura, Wolfie, Pebble, and Aeon Lost versus Nexurin, PD Prox, Mortal Striker, and Painketsu. So I am eagerly awaiting if Mortal Striker will once again carry the deck, or Painketsu will... Well, we'll see.
Before we get into this match, I can reveal the winner of the Brazil versus Sweden. The tiebreaker has concluded. Brazil have won the tiebreaker and are going through in second place in Group H with a 500k difference in that match. A really close game over there. Sweden gave it a good shot, but Brazil are the victors. And that means Hong Kong will be going out and Brazil will be progressing to the round of 16.
I almost feel sad Hong Kong's going out after the quite... impressive performance that they were giving. So we've got Nexurin is going to be doing the Hidden Hard Rock for the side of Spain, and Aeon Lost also with the Hidden Hard Rock on the side of Mexico. So we've got this relatively slow build-up. Let's see how this goes. Are you putting your hands together, and are you getting this party started? Those are the important questions for this map.
You better.
Oh, we've got Aeon Lust already missing Hidden Hard Rock. It's a powerful opponent. Mortal Striker with the miss as well. Nexurin sitting... Accuracy not doing too well, but he's got the combo going. That's all that really matters at this point.
If we can FC this, it'll be super impressive, of course. It's ambitious. There's only one full combo on this map. That's his on the leaderboards by Rohul, but you never know.
It could happen. I'm holding my heart out for a miracle. So we've got Mexico holding the lead for now, with the early breaks punishing Spain far more than the Mexican side, because Mexico have kind of recovered in that regard. Oh, missing on a relatively easy slider there. He's going to be slightly annoyed about that. So our hidden hard rock hero is unfortunately falling
below the line.
So what do you think about the prevalence of more technical maps in the OSU World Cup map pool as opposed to the just generally quite difficult or fast or jumpy maps that we saw in previous years?
I think in this pool there are plenty of more standard maps in there. But there are a few technical ones, as you say. It's a really popular map install in the modern age, the last couple of years. There's been loads of maps with lots of these slider spam patterns, but I think there's been a fair few standard ones in here. I mean, it's a nice mixture. It tests more elements of the game, you know?
Because I do like the fact that you have, in the same map pool, there are like 4.5 star maps with AR8 to challenge reading, and then you have the your typical like AR9.4 6 star map. You just generally test aim and speed and things like that. And we've got PD Prox with the 1000 combo. He's the highest on the board, Mortal Striker in a close second behind him. So he's the main driving force behind Spain's not huge lead at this point, but they're doing pretty well. Though the accuracy is coming to bite him a little bit.
That combo, though, is going to carry his team. It's so much harder than everything else.
On the side of Mexico, we've got only two. only two combos above 100. So Hibble, he's got good accuracy, but he's not got the combo to back it up.
So I'm causing some problems for people. But Spain showing up.
They really are indeed. PD Prox is taking no prisoners. And we're going through the relatively easy stream part, so this is where the combo can really kind of build up. If he maintains his combo through this, he's looking in a pretty good position to carry his team. And Penketsu always dropping the 1k combo, so hope still remains for Mexico. But it would require PD Prox to drop in the next few notes, really.
Has to. He's single-handedly beaten Mexico with that combo. Mexico's bringing it back though. Hable, Atsura, Wolfie, bringing it back now during that slow part, but it's not enough right now. They need something from Spain right now to drop.
They need PD Prox to miss at this point. And now the map is speeding up. We're hitting slightly more adventurous part of it. Glider's getting a little bit more spaced out. Aim gets a little bit harder. But he's still holding strong. He's showing no signs of weakness. And it's starting to get to the point where it might be too late. There's still a bit of room, but we've got a few drops coming out from Wolfie, from Aeon Dust, and I think in the end, he's going to carry this. So this match will end up most likely being a comeback on the back of PD Prox's combo on the tiebreaker.
Despite the odds and despite the fact that Spain had so many difficulties in the earlier matches, they really went out with a bang on this one. Coming back from almost looking like, you know, they were just going to go out with a whimper, but no, they go out with a win. 4-3. The winners are Spain, taking this one with that PD Prox FC carrying his team to victory. And even though they are going out, they won't be going out bottom. And the first Spanish team in around 6 years ends on a very strong performance. Well done, Spain.
Yep, Mortal Striker, the only S on the board, and PD Prox with the FC. You got 2-1 missed scores on the side of Mexico, so they're no slouches either. So generally a good performance from Spain on the tiebreaker. And showing that even though they may be out of the tournament, they are not playing poorly by any means.
And there we go.
Yeah, that was the group stage for 2016.
The group stage has now concluded.
That was a pretty good group stage, I must say.
So many good matches, and there's a ton of upsets as well. I mean, going into this, looking at some of the players some of the lower seed teams had, I knew something was going to happen, and it didn't disappoint. That said, though, admittedly, a lot of the teams going through are the ones we expected, but it came so close for a few teams.
Like South Korea, China, Taiwan, Poland, these teams are we're expected to go do pretty well. But groups, well, it's, I think, like, closely contested groups, like Group H, like Group F as well, but that was a factor. Latvia put up a good showing, but didn't quite work out. New Zealand as well, we had the story of a certain potato doing quite well.